And hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Francisco, and today we're diving into a super frustrating issue that a lot of iPhone users run into, that dreaded iPhone error 4013. In this video, I'll walk you through three solid methods to fix iPhone error 4013, including a super clean, no data loss solution using Dr.Fone that honestly saved me a ton of time. Now, let's get started. Starting off with part 1, what is iPhone error 4013 and why does it happen? So let's start with what this error actually even is. iPhone error 4013 is basically your phone telling you, hey, now something went wrong during the restore or update process. And most of the time, that something is a communication issue between your iPhone and iTunes, not really a hardware failure of any kind. It can be caused by a sketchy USB cable, an outdated iTunes version, or just a random iOS bug, but don't worry, we're gonna troubleshoot it step by step. Moving on to part 2, method number 1, start with the basics. So before we dive into software tools or recovery modes, try this first. Make sure that you're using an original Apple cable or a certified one. I know, everyone says this, but seriously, non-certified cables are one of the top reasons for error 4013. So my suggestion is just to avoid USB hubs or splitters. Plug your iPhone directly into your PC. Now open iTunes, head to help, check for updates, and install anything new. You want the latest version, especially if you're using a newer iPhone model. Now, sometimes these simple steps are enough to fix the problem, but if not, let's move on to the next solution. Moving on to part 3, method number 2, use recovery mode or DFU mode. Now, next up, we've got recovery mode and DFU mode. These are Apple's built-in ways to reset your iPhone when it's acting up and you can't do it manually through your own iOS device. So to enter recovery mode, you need the following. Plug your iPhone into your PC. Quickly press and release the volume up button, then the volume down button. Press and hold the side button until you see the recovery mode screen, that cable to computer icon that we're so used to seeing. Now iTunes or Finder will then prompt you to restore or update. Try update first to keep your data. If recovery mode doesn't work, DFU mode is a deeper level restoration process. And it's a bit more advanced, it doesn't really show anything on the screen, but it is worth a shot. Now with that said, if you want something a little bit easier, no button combos, no data loss, check out the next method. Now moving on to part 4, method number 3, the easiest fix with Dr.Fone system repair. Alright, this is hands down the easiest and most user-friendly solution that I have found, Wondershare Dr.Fone system repair. This tool can fix over 150 iOS system issues, including error 4013, boot loops, black screens, and best of all, it can do it without wiping your data. Now here's how it works. Download Dr.Fone from the link in the description, which is going to work on both Mac and Windows. Open the software and select System Repair from the home screen. Plug in your iPhone and choose Standard Mode. This is key. Standard Mode keeps your data completely intact. The tool will then detect your iPhone model and asks to download the right firmware. Once that's done, just hit Repair Now. And that's pretty much it. After a few minutes, your iPhone should reboot. No more 4013 error, and everything on your phone stays as it was before. This method is especially useful if you've already tried iTunes and recovery mode with no luck. Personally, I use Dr.Fone whenever iTunes gives me trouble. It's fast, simple, and way less stressful. Now part 5, bonus tips to avoid 4013 in the future. A couple of quick tips to help you avoid running into this issue again. Always use certified or original charging cables. Keep both your iOS and iTunes up to date at all times. And don't interrupt updates, let them fully complete. And every once in a while, restart your phone to clear out temporary system bugs or even just clear up some of its cache. Also, if you ever feel like your iPhone is laggy or acting weird, running Dr.Fone system repair tool every few months can actually help to keep your device healthy. Alright, let's do a quick recap. So for the first method, check your cable and make sure iTunes is updated. For the second method, try recovery mode or DFU mode. For the third method, use Dr.Fone system repair for a safe, one-click fix, no data loss, no hassle. If this video helped you out, please go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you want more practical iPhone tutorials and troubleshooting tips, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications. And until next time.